Previously, we've talked about validity and soundness as important properties that a deductive argument can have. But what about inductive arguments? All right, let's consider the following piece of inductive reasoning. Everyone in Bob's office has the flu. Bob's family has the flu. Bob's friends have the flu. So Bob has the flu as well. Now, does this seem like a good inductive argument or a bad one? Well, given the evidence presented in the premises, it sure does seem likely that Bob would have the flu as well. So it strikes me as a pretty good argument. But of course, it's not a valid argument, since we can easily imagine a situation in which all of those people have the flu, but by some miracle, Bob managed to not get it. So it's not a valid argument, but it does seem to exhibit good reasoning, right? Now remember that inductive arguments and deductive arguments differ in the kind of support that they're supposed to provide for the conclusion. Deductive arguments are supposed to provide absolute proof, but an inductive argument can be perfectly rational even if it doesn't provide conclusive proof of the conclusion. So instead of talking about validity, when we're judging the reasoning in an inductive argument, we will say that it is either strong or weak. A strong inductive argument is one that offers really good evidence to support the conclusion. It means that the conclusion is really likely to be true on the assumption that the premises are true. Whereas a weak inductive argument is one that uses weak or poor evidence. So even if the premises are taken to be true, it still doesn't make the conclusion all that likely. Similarly to the notion of validity, when judging the strength of an inductive argument, we take the premises for granted and ignore the question of whether they are true in reality. So the following is a fairly strong inductive argument, even though the premises are in fact false. Poodles can fly, golden retrievers can fly, bulldogs can fly, labradors can fly, therefore all dogs can fly. Even though the premises are all patently false, if we imagine that they're true, then it seems like the conclusion is pretty likely to be true as well. So it's a strong inductive argument. On the other hand, contrast that with the following. Lions can talk, cheetahs can talk, so all animals can talk. Okay, let's suppose the premises are true. Still, isn't it kind of a leap to infer that all animals can talk on the basis of just two examples? This argument does not provide much evidence for the conclusion, even on the assumption that the premises are true. So it's definitely a weak inductive argument. In general, strong inductive arguments tend to use a lot of data points to support the conclusion, while weak arguments use only a few. So strength is basically the inductive analog of validity. They both pertain to the quality of the reasoning involved in the argument. But what about soundness? Is there an inductive version of soundness? There is, and it's known as cogency. Now remember that soundness is essentially validity plus true premises. So similarly, cogency is strength plus true premises. A cogent argument is one in which the conclusion is most likely to be true given the premises, and the premises are in fact true. So just like with soundness, cogency does care about whether the premises are true in reality. So if we go back to this argument, we can say that it is a strong inductive argument, but not a cogent one, since all of the premises are false. Now, unlike with soundness, a cogent argument does not have to have a true conclusion. Since a strong inductive argument only means that the conclusion is very likely to be true, given the premises, an argument can have true premises and use good inductive reasoning, but still end up with a false conclusion. Finally, one more thing to note is that unlike validity, inductive strength is a matter of degree. Inductive arguments provide more or less support for the conclusion, but there isn't a clear standard of what counts as enough evidence to qualify as a strong argument. So whenever it's relevant, we'll try to stick with examples that are very obviously strong or very obviously weak. Okay, so in this video, we covered strong versus weak inductive arguments and cogent versus non-cogent inductive arguments. And these concepts are basically analogs of the deductive notions of validity and soundness, although they differ in subtle ways.